Good morning, dear students. Today I'm going to take a very small topic which is called as sensory re-education in neurophysiotherapy. So as the name itself implies, here we are going to understand about the re-education or retraining of sensation. Normally, whenever a person undergoes any kind of accidents, injuries relating to lower motor neuron or upper motor neuron problem pathologies, that person may lose abilities such as function, mobility and all, but along with that, sensation also will be lost or altered. Abnormal sensation may be there. So as a physiotherapist, we have to understand how to incorporate retraining techniques, re-education of various exercises, how we can bring back the old, the normal which the patient experienced earlier before the injury. So normalizing the sensation using sensory re-education means already which has been studied by the trained by the person throughout his life, and whatever sensation sensory skills he or she has learned has to be re-educated. Sensory re-education is a type of cognitive behavioral therapy technique. It is also referred to as sensory retraining. These techniques have a meaningful impact on the quality of life in patients with nerve injuries following a stroke or other brain injuries, as well as patients with foot and ankle neuropathies in case of diabetes. In the case of lower extremity sensory impairment, the training is proven to reduce falls and fall-related injuries, as well as correct the balance. So correcting the balance, balance is actually a feedback to lot of sensory sensations which are coming to the brain. So once if the sensations are not perceived well by the brain, balance is going to be affected. Peripheral nerve injuries of the hand have a high incidence with consequences related to loss of mobility, loss of sensation and loss of function. Upper motor neuron lesions also leads to sensory dysfunctions related to tactile dysfunctions, proprioceptive dysfunction, auditory dysfunction, visual dysfunction, vestibular dysfunction, olfactory dysfunction and gustatory, that is taste dysfunction. A sensory re-education program in the early post-operative phase or rehabilitative phase before any re-innovation hypothetically helps to preserve the somatosensory cortical representation of the hand and to reduce or inhibit the cortical reorganization that would occur without early intervention. Dear students, you have to understand that this education program, it's like an education program. Re-education program is a sensory re-education program which we are going to give to the patient, most probably in a post-operative condition. So early pre-post-operative itself we have to intervene. Why we have to do that? Because after the particular injury or a pathology, the person's brain, which has to represent the area in the brain which was representing that area, for example, if the hand was affected, the area representing the hand in the brain was not at all receiving any perception, not at all receiving any sensation. So that area was, you know, not functioning. So incorporating some kind of technique, understanding how to, you know, stimulate the area of that brain is what we call as early pre-operative as well as early post-operative re-education program, because it will create facilitation of the cortical reorganization which will not occur without any early intervention. After a nerve repair or cortical lesion, sensibility and muscle function in parts of the body can be altering or abnormal. and intolerance to sensory stimuli is common. So the patients will show abnormal behavior or, you know, aversion or what we call as discomfort. So this intolerance to a particular sensory stimuli is due to the cortical problem. The cortex is not, you know, perceiving in a way it was perceiving earlier. Because of the injury, it is perceiving in a wrong way. So right, we should understand that, and sensory re-education technique should be given appropriately to solve the problem. After the surgery, when the nerve sheath is repaired, new nerve axons grow into the skin and the muscles. So after the surgery, what will happen? That surgeon will try to keep the stitch of the nerve, and the nerve which was tethered or cut has to grow slowly. Only it will happen. It cannot happen very fastly. So this we have to, the therapist should have a good knowledge about that re-innervation, how it happens, what kind of re-innervation is happening, what kind of, sensations are affected, how it is changed, and when it is healing, it will not heal exactly in the way we desire. There will be a lot of adverse sensory, problems may come. So some of the examples which I can quote is hypersensitivity to light touch. So light touch itself, touching a simple touch itself will create a hyperactive, hypersensitivity, showing a big response during this growth period, but can be influenced by the so-called desensitization. So we have to use a gradual method called as desensitization, when the skin gradually gets used to normal touch again. It takes a long time for the nerve to grow. Approximately, it grows only 1 millimeter per day. The peripheral nerve grows only 1 millimeter per day. The result is a new sensibility that you have to learn to interpret. The brain has a detailed map of the body where touch is registered and expressed or interpreted. You have studied that in the physiology, the somatosensory area and the areas of the Brodmann areas of the brain, which and all area is representing what and all functions. So with that knowledge, you using this technique, touch from the right hand, for example, touch in the on the right hand mainly processed in the left part of the brain, but both of the brain are active during perception of the touch. All our senses cooperate when we touch something. When we are touching something, not only the touch sensation is coming, all other senses also coming. Our vision, where we are touching, in the room, what is the, sounds, any sounds are coming, position of our joints, proprioceptive, smell of the room, any fragrance is there. All those senses are coming to the brain. Touch is also coming. Along with that, many other sensation is also coming. So we are going to use the other, if touch is affected, we are going to use the other senses to train these patients to strengthen that sensation of touch. A repaired nerve means the brain program for the interpretation of touch input for a period of time is silent. So it was silent. The touch was affected. The nerve which was carrying the touch sensation was affected. That means that the area in the brain where the touch was perceived is silent for some time, since there is no or very little sensibility in the hand. So we will start this from the, here we say the area is called as, the time period is called as phase 1. In this phase 1, during this period, the hand map in the brain is also rapidly occupied by adjacent areas and is changing. So it may, the hand map of the brain, so here we are talking about the touch of the hand. That example is touch sensation of the hand. So it was in silent phase, means there is no sensation coming from the hand. That means adjacent areas may try to start functioning. Why there is no sensation coming? So the adjacent areas will try to get some, maybe I will take up the job, like that. It will think about, change, taking up the job. When the new axons have grown, so the area of the brain is also affected when the silent happened. And now when the new axons are growing, the new axons which are new to this function, which is any sense. For here, we are using touch. So touch sensation has to be carried out by these new axons. So the new axons and the new map formed in the brain altogether don't know how to work exactly, and it takes time for the after the injury for the person to relate this. So physiotherapists with good idea about this can help the patient very well. So the hand map becomes unstructured and the sensibility during this time is not very useful. So during the phase one, what happens is there is no silent phase and this new area is taking up, so this is not very useful. So to overcome this, you need the patient will naturally use other sensation, mainly the vision, to understand what the hand is touching, and then he or she will relate that to the old sensation they had. So in phase two, this functional reorganization of the brain is a natural process and depends on the brain's capacity to adapt when the body sends new signals. So phase two, the reorganization is happening, trial and error method is happening, the person will use all other sensations to understand the new way, the new abnormal sensation, the recovering sensation is perceived by him or her. So what are the re-education exercises? Now that you got the idea of what we are doing, now how are we going to do this? Sensory re-education exercises consist of stimulating different senses including tactile, olfactory, auditory, visual, orofacial, that is related to chewing, tasting, all those kind of stimulation, taste sense, and also the proprioception, which is a joint and the sense, that is kinesthetic sense. Use of this rehabilitative approach is very common after nerve injuries, especially of the hand. We are talking more about the hand because it is the most complicated and most useful part of the human body, and which is the area we use sensory re-education exercise more, where an impairment has occurred affecting the way the brain interprets senses. Symptoms of sensory impairment can manifest. So any sensory impairment will be manifested such as numbness, tingling, inability to feel, that is thermal sensation, heat or cold cannot be sensed by the person in that area which is affected, or sometimes hypersensitivity. The exercise should be done for several times per day. Make sure you are in a quiet and comfortable place. Quiet and comfortable place is very, very essential because you don't want to, you know, bombard the patient with a lot of sensation. We are controlling the sensation here, and where the patient can concentrate, because it's a cognitive and behavioral technique. Training in phase one. In phase one, the hand is without sensitivity, and the hand in the brain has the hand map in the brain has disappeared. This phase lasts up to 3 months. Not in all injury, we are talking about any cortical injury at the wrist level, and encompasses a period direct after surgery. So if you are going for any surgery after traumatic problem, until some growing axons have reached the palm of the hand. During this phase, we have no protective sensibility. Usually protective sensation is there, no? Somebody touches a hand, some thermal sensation, somebody pricks you, or we will remove the hand, that is protection. Here it will not be present because of the loss of those protective sensibility axons. So you have to watch for prevent. So our first phase, we have to teach the patient to prevent any skin injuries. The sensory relearning technique is in this early phases, combination with training of the mobility of the hand, is aimed at activating and maintaining the hand map in the brain to make the sensory relearning easier once the axons have regrown. So once the axons have regrown, this will help them to prevent any kind of illusion of their hand insensibility in the brain. So training has to be repeated several times per day. So what are the exercises we can give? Touch a hidden texture. Hidden texture, different texture which is hidden. First, hidden shape, hidden object. Try to give different objects with closed eye, then open eye, and ask them to judge the object. So these kind of, you know, giving different textures, giving different shapes, giving different objects, then giving ask them to do different tasks with these objects, with eye closed, eye opened, these kind of exercises. For example, I am giving Rubik's Cube as an example. These kind of activities using touch, vision, proprioception, stereognosis, all has to be implied. So further, I will be taking this more in the practical sessions. Thank you.